Hi all, today we can discuss about Miller indices. It comes under the topic of crystallography. In the study of various crystal structures, we are dealing with a number of lattice planes. So we can consider a crystal as an aggregate of a number of planes. Crystal planes we can consider in different ways. Some lattice planes are parallel to the surface, some are inclined to the surface, and etc. So it is important that we have to know about the position and the orientation of crystal planes in a crystal. So a British scientist Miller suggested a method to show the orientation of a particular lattice plane in a crystal. So this scheme, which represents a particular plane in a crystal, that is known as Miller indices. Miller indices are three integers which represent the position and orientation of a lattice plane in a crystal. Now we can see how to represent this lattice plane in this crystal structure. So here, this unit cell have three crystallographic axes. This is the origin O. So here we can consider X axis, this is Y axis, and it is Z axis. So this side of this X axis is A, along the Y axis it is B, along the Z axis it is C. We can name this lattice plane as A, B, C. Now this ABC lattice plane is having an intercept of OA along X axis. Okay. And it is having an intercept of OB along Y axis. And the intercept along Z axis is OC. Let OA equal to A by 2 and OB is B by 2. OC is C. Now, we can write the intercept along X, Y, Z axis. OA is A by 2. OB is B by 2, OC is C. Now, to find the Miller indices, take the reciprocal of the intercept of this plane on the three crystallographic axes. The intercepts along X axis is 1 by 2, along Y axis 1 by 2, along Z axis we can denote it as 1. Take the reciprocal of this intercept, that is 2 by 1, 2 by 1, 1 by 1, that is we are getting 2, 2, 1. So we can represent this plane as 2, 2, 1. These three integers in this curved packet is known as Miller indices of this plane. So how to find out the Miller indices of a particular plane in a crystal? We have to find out the intercept along X, Y and Z axis. Take the reciprocal of these intercepts and write those integers within a curved packet. Then that will represent the Miller indices. In general, we can write the Miller indices as HKL. Now we can consider one more plane. This is 2C. So to find out the Miller indices of this blue color ABC plane, first we have to find out the X intercept, that is equal to OA, and to find out the Y intercept is OB, Z intercept is OC. So OA is length A and OB is length B and OC is length 2C. So what are the intercepts we can write it as coefficient? So it is 1, it is along the Y axis it is 1, along Z axis is 2. So now we have to take the reciprocal. So when we take the reciprocal, it becomes 1 by 1, 1 by 1 and 1 by 2. Now we have to write this in a bracket. Whatever we got as HKL are not integers. It is compulsory that the Miller indices must be integers. So if we are getting fraction, we have to simplify that fractions into integers. How can we simplify the fractions into integers? For that we have to multiply it with the LCM. So what is the LCM here? 2. Just multiply it by LCM. Then what we are getting? 2, 2, 1. So this is the Miller indices. So Miller indices is 2, 2, 1. So this lattice plane we can represent as 2, 2, 1. So we can brief out the method of finding the Miller indices in this way. First, we have to find out the intercepts along X axis, Y axis and Z axis. Let OE, OB, OC are the X, Y and Z intercept. Now take the OA. OA is equal to PA. OB is equal to QB. OC equal to RC. where A, B, C are the side of this unit cell along X, Y and Z axis. Now to find out the intercepts, we can divide this by lattice constant A, B, C. So PA by A, QB by B, RC by C. So we are getting PQR as the intercepts. Then take the reciprocal of these intercepts, that is 1 by P, 1 by Q, 1 by R. These are known as Miller indices, HKL. Now, if we are getting integer directly, it is correct. But if we are getting the fraction, that is not allowed. We have to simplify that fraction into smallest integer by multiplying it with the LCM. Now, if the Miller indices and lattice parameters are given, that is HKL and ABC are given, to find the X, Y and Z intercept, we can use these formulas. X intercept is equal to A by H, Y intercept equal to B by K, Z intercept equal to C by L. Now, we can see one more example. A crystal plane that how X intercept as 3A, Y intercept 2B and Z intercept 1C. Now find the Miller indices. So how to find out the Miller indices? First we have to take this intercept coefficients, that is 3, 2, 1. Then take the reciprocal 1 by 3, 1 by 2, 1. So these are fractions. So we have to simplify it by multiplying with LCM. That is 6 by 3 is 2, 6 by 2 is 3 and 6. So 2, 3, 6 is the corresponding Miller index. Now we can find out the Miller indices of these three crystal planes. See the first lattice plane with the blue shader region. First find out the X, Y and Z intercept. Then take the reciprocal. Then that will give the Miller indices. So what is the X intercept here? This is origin O. So X intercept is A. What is the Y intercept here? Is this lattice plane touching the Y axis? No. So, we can take that the intercept along the y-axis is infinity because it is not touching anywhere on this y-axis here. So, that means it have an infinity intercept along the y-axis. Now, what about along the z-axis? Is it have any intercept along the z-axis? We can't see. That means the intercept of this lattice plane along the z-axis is infinity. So, the intercept along xyz-axis of this plane is A, infinity, infinity. Now, what we have to do? We have to take the PQR values. That is, here it is PA, QB, RC. Now, divide it by A, B, C. So, what we are getting here, it is 1. Now, infinity, infinity. Now, take the reciprocal. So, on taking the reciprocal, this is 1. This is 1 by infinity and this is 1 by infinity. So, what is 1? 1 by infinity is 0 and 1 by infinity here also 0. So, this lattice plane we can denote as 1, 0, 0. Okay. Now, see the second lattice plane. Here, it is having an x-intercept A, y-intercept B and is it having any z-intercept? No. So, what we have to take? We have to take the z-intercept as infinity. So, taking this coefficient, that is 1, 1, infinity. Now, take the reciprocal, that is 1, 1, 1 by infinity, that is 1, 1, 0. So, the Miller indices of this crystal plane is 1, 1, 0. Now, take this crystal plane. It is in triangular shape. So, here we can write the X intercept, Y intercept and Z intercept. What is X intercept? A. Y intercept? B. Z intercept? C. Now we have to take this coefficient, that is 1, 1, 1. So now take the reciprocal, that is 1, 1, 1. So Miller indices is 1, 1, 1. So here the plane is 1, 0, 0. Here the plane is 1, 1, 0. Here the plane is 1, 1, 1. So, in the Miller indices, if we have a 0, that means the intercept along that axis is infinity. Now, why we are taking the reciprocal? Because in order to avoid the infinity from these Miller indices, we are taking the reciprocal. This 1, 0, 0 plane, 1, 1, 0 plane and 1, 1, 1 plane are very important in crystal structure study. So, they are known as the principal planes in the crystallography. 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1, 1. Okay. The Miller indices 100, 010, 001 are also come under the 100 family. Similarly, 110, 101, 011 are come under the 110 family. Now, if the intercept are along the negative axis, we are putting that by a bar on the top of the Miller index. These 100 planes are known as surface planes. 110 planes are known as inclined plane or oblique plane. And 111 planes are triangular planes. Can you say what's the shape of these planes? The first plane is 123 plane. So there is no zero there. So it will be a triangular plane like this. Now 101 is having a zero there. So it will be an inclined plane. In the third one, it is having two zeros. So that means it will be a surface plane. See this question. A plane cuts intercepts 3A, 3B and 2C along the axis in a crystal. Determine Miller indices of that plane. So the intercepts are given. That is PA, QB, RC. The intercepts are given as 3A, 3B, 2C. Now what we have to write from here? The either coefficient, that is PQR. What are they? 3, 3, 2. Now we have to take the reciprocal. That is 1 by P, 1 by Q, 1 by R. That is 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 2. Now these reciprocals are fractions. So we have to multiply this with the LCM. So LCM here is 6. So 6 into 1 by 3, 2. 6 into 1 by 3, 2. 6 by 2. That is 3. So the Miller indices in this question is 2, 2, 3. Next question. In a triclinic crystal, a lattice plane makes intercept at a length A, 2B and 3C by 2. Find the Miller indices. So here we can write the PQR as A coefficient is 1, B coefficient is 2 and C coefficient is minus 3 by 2. Next what we have to do? We have to take the reciprocal. So what is the reciprocal here? 1, 1 by 2 minus 2 by 3. Here the reciprocal is fraction, so we have to multiply with the LCM. So LCM is 6. So here on multiplying we are getting 6. 6 by 2 is 3. So 6 by 3, 2 into 2, that is 4. Now see this, the intercept is along the negative z axis. So in order to show that negative z axis, we have to put a bar over 4. So the Miller indices for this given plane is 6, 3, 4 bar. Next question. A plane cuts intercepts A, 2B and infinity along axis in a crystal. So the intercepts are A, 2B, infinity. Determine Miller indices. So that is PQRR 1, 2, infinity. Now we have to take the reciprocal. That is 1 by P, 1 by Q, 1 by R. And it is giving 1 by 1, 1 by 2, 1 by infinity. Okay. So this is HKLs, but in the HKL we have fraction, that is not allowed. So we have to multiply by LCM. Here LCM is 2. That is 2, 1, 1 by infinity is 0. So the given plane having a Miller indices of 2, 1, 0. Next question. A plane cuts intercepts of 2, 2 by 3 along x and y axis of a crystal. Determine Miller indices of that plane parallel to z axis. So how can we do this? Here the intercepts along x and y axis are given as 2 and 2 by 3. And we have to find out the Miller indices of that plane parallel to z axis. So parallel to z axis means what will be the intercept along z axis? That will be infinity. So now we can do. So this is PQR. So HKL is the reciprocal of this. That is, on taking reciprocal, 1 by 2, 3 by 2, 1 by infinity. Okay. So these are Miller indices, but it contains fractions. So we have to multiply this by LCM. LCM is 2. That is 2 into 1 by 2 is 1. 2 into 3 by 2 is 3. And 2 by infinity, that is 0. So the Miller indices for the given plane is 1, 3, 0. Okay. Now a plane makes intercepts of 1, to 0.5 angstrom on crystallographic axis of an orthorhombic crystal with A is to B is to C is 3 is to 2 is to 1. Determine Miller indices. So it is given the A, B, C ratio as 3 to 1. That is, lattice constant are in the ratio 3 is to 2 is to 1. Now the intercepts are given. So what is the intercept along x axis, y axis, z axis? That is PA, QB, RC. So here it is PA, QB, RC. They are in the ratio 1 to 0.5. So from this we can find out the value of PQR. What will be PQR? That is PA is 1, A is 3. So P is 1 by 3, Q is 2 by 2 and R is 0.5 by 1. So now we got the value of PQR. So what is Miller indices? Miller indices is the reciprocal of this. That is 1 by P, 1 by Q, 1 by R. That is 1 by 3 reciprocal is 3. 2 by 2 is 1. Its reciprocal is 1. 0.5 by 1 is half. So that's reciprocal is 2. So the Miller indices are 3, 1, 2. One last question. In a crystal whose primitive vectors are 1.2 angstrom, 1.8 angstrom, 2 angstrom for 2-3-1 plane that cuts an intercept of 1.2 angstrom along x-axis, find intercept along y and z-axis. So in the crystal, primitive vectors are given. Primitive vectors means the value of ABC. They are given as 1.2 angstrom, 1.8 angstrom and 2 angstrom. So, for which plane? 2, 3, 1 plane. So, what is the meaning of that? H is equal to 2, K is equal to 3 and L is equal to 1. X intercept is given as 1.2 angstrom. We have to find out the Y and Z intercepts. So, we can find out the intercept using this formula. That is, X intercept is equal to A by H. Y intercept is equal to B by K. Z intercept is equal to C by L. So A is equal to 1.2 angstrom divided by H. H is 2. That is 0.6 angstrom. So here B is 1.8 angstrom divided by K is 3. That is 0.6 angstrom. And C is 2 angstrom divided by 1. That is equal to 2 angstrom. Okay, now in the question it's already given this x intercept is equal to 1.2 angstrom, but from calculation we got 0.6 angstrom. That means the given plane in the question is some other plane that will be parallel to these intercepts. All the parallel planes we can represent by same Miller indices. So here the given x-intercept is 1.2 angstrom. That means here 2 into 0.6 is 1.6 angstrom. That is another plane that is parallel to the plane with these intercepts. So for y-intercept and z-intercept also we have to multiply with 2. So 0.6 into 2, that is 1.2 angstrom. Here 2 into 2, that is 4 angstrom. So, in this question, the intercept along y and z axis are 1.2 angstrom and 4 angstrom respectively. Okay, so try more questions.